Hi, today I will discuss about TRUSS solving in MATLAB. This is the TRUSS example that I will solve in the MATLAB. So you see here, there is node number 1, node 2, like that, total 9 load, and there is total 15 element, and this is the load, this is the load, and this and this is the dimension, and this is the bar properties in here, elastic modulus area, like this. So horizontal members, there is two members. This is the horizontal member and this is diagonal member, so the properties are different. So let's go, how can I solve it? So this is the main truss file. So let's run it. So it says that results printed in file truss 2 result. Go to truss 2. See here, this is the main result file, and there is element 4 section. It is compression or tension. So there also nodal displacement solution vector. So in a truss, mainly we need displacement and member force action, and this is the another, this is the coordinate of node number 1, node number 9, xy coordinate, and this is the node displacement and element properties, and element node 1, this is node xy, and this is the properties which I will input in the main file. So mainly I copyright it, this main file from a books. It called Introduction of Finite Element Analysis Using MATLAB and Abqus. So let's go the data file. This is the data file. So this is the number of nodes. So you see here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, total and 9 number, and this is the number of element. That means there are 15 bars total, and this is the number of nodes per element. That means for example, this element has 2 nodes, like number 1 and number 3. So number of node is total 2, 1 and 3. So I write in here number of nodes per element 2. Okay, so and then number of degree of freedom per node, I mean this we will like that x and y. When I go to number node, similarly summation of horizontal x, summation of horizontal y. So this is the number of degree of freedom 2. And this is the number of degree of freedom per element. This element degree of freedom, it means multiply this. And this is the nodes coordinate. I mean, for node number 1, the coordinate are 0. For node number 3, like that here, the coordinate is 2 meter here, and y coordinate is 0. So node number node number 3, 2 meter, and the coordinate is 0, y coordinate is 0. So I write in here, you can see it. So and I give all the node coordinate. Like for example, if you go number 8 node, so the x coordinate and y coordinate is definitely 2, and x coordinate is x coordinate is 7, and this is called geometric function. And first, when I take the geometric function, I make it totally 0, and that means zeros n and d 2. So let's go here, geom, see here geometric function, and first I have make this 0. First I make this vector matrix total is 0, and then I put the number according to the coordinate, because sometimes if you define this geomatrix in another file, so sometimes Matlab take this geom from this other file, so there is some problem. So that's why I make it total 0 and then put the number. And you see here one, then there is global NND, and that means if I want to mention this geomatrix in another Matlab file, that means here like the TRUSS here NND and geom, you see here geomatrix. So geomatrix is comes from here, main data file. So this matrix you can use this matrix in another Matlab file. That's why I make it global. When you make global, you can use this thing in another Matlab file. Okay, and this is the connection file. Similarly, I make it 0, and let's go connection. How can it connect it? So node number 1 connect with node number 2, and as well node number 1 connected node number 3. Similarly, 2 connect 3, 3 connect 4, and 2 connect 4, like that. So it depends on number of element, how many number of element you have. And 2 means there is 2 column, this and this. I mean 1 connect with 3, 1 connect with 2. So you have to mention 2 node at a time, 1 and 3, 1 and 3, 1 and 2, 1 like that. And the next one is geometrics, geometrical properties. Again, I make the properties matrix 0, and there is 2 type of properties like that. When you take the element number 1, element number 1, this is diagonal. So diagonal E has elastic modulus has this, that means 30 to the power 6, and cross section has 0.02 meter. And when you take the element number 2 here, the element number 2 has this elastic modulus and this cross sections of 0.05. Like that way I define all of the members in here. This is the properties matrix, it calls properties matrix. And go to boundary condition. So boundary condition here, this is nodal freedom of node 1, prescribed nodal freedom. That means NF means nodal freedom. So here this is number of node and number of degree of freedom. Okay, and then this is one of the loop, that means I equals I NND. So NND I means number of node 9. So for each 1 to NND. Okay, let's run it so you can understand. So you see here, I will become 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, up to 9. So for this is for loop. For loop will execute for 1, and that the execution will be I guess to 1, and it will move. Again for I guess to 2, it will move again. I guess to 3, it will move again. This is the for loop, and last one is load matrix. So load matrix, again I make it 0, and you see here at the node number 2 here, the load is horizontally 50 kilonewton and vertically 0. So I make it node number 2 and this is the that means column 1 and column 2. So column 1 is 15 and column 2 is 0. I define this. Similarly, when you go to this node number 3, so this is the 3 and the column, and so this is the vertical, so this is minus 5. I mean I take upward is positive and downward is negative. Similarly, node number 4, there is 7 vertical, and at node number 7 again this is minus 10 in here. So this is the input file. This is the input file, and I talk about in my recent videos about main file, Finite TRUSS, KL TRUSS G, and other files, and how to form it. So I request the viewers to go to my recent video and see it. And if you need the tutorial, or if you need the TRUSS coding, MATLAB coding, please give the comment in the video so that I can understand you. And the main file, this main file TRUSS result, these are the same. Just I change the input file. When you change the input file, the other file are same. So you can solve as many TRUSS as you can. Like change the thing here. You can give here like 10 or something. So define this 10 in here also. I'll just change it so you can solve it in the MATLAB. So thanks for watching my video, and if you like the video, please subscribe my channel. Thank you.